Okay, the next question is on foreign policy. If our intelligence suggested that Al-Qaeda was functionally operating in Pakistan or Yemen, or just for the sake of argument, somewhere like China, would you support military action without the host country's consent?
No.
Why?
We cannot, without the country's consent?
Without the host country's consent, would you support military action without the host country's consent if we had intelligence showing that Al-Qaeda was functionally operating in a foreign country, whether it be Pakistan, Yemen, wherever?
I would not, because that's intruding on the sovereignty of that nation, and we may precipitate a greater war than we're trying to avert. So I would not go into another country without their consent.
Thank you. Mr. Bender.
The number one priority of our federal government, John, is to keep America safe. And we have to do that by whatever means necessary. However, we would first want to use every diplomatic action to inform China or Pakistan or whichever country it might be that we believe that there's a threat to the United States in their country and try and address it with the cooperation of that host country. I think as a first step to unilaterally invade any country because you believe that Al-Qaeda might be there would be an overreaction. Now, that having been said, there are a number of problems in the world that require cooperation of all our allies. You know, when I look around the globe, we've got nuclear proliferation in Iran as well as North Korea. We've got the war on terror in Pakistan and Afghanistan. We've got problems with managing OPEC. We've got nuclear problems with neighbors from around Israel, India, Pakistan, and China, Taiwan. All of these things require the cooperation of other countries, and we should avoid acting unilaterally wherever we can and do it with the cooperation of those host countries.
Mr. LaMontagne.
Thank you for the question, John. Clearly, if Al-Qaeda or any terrorist organization poses a clear and present threat to the United States or one of its allies, and after giving due notice and an opportunity to cure, to fix the problem by the host country, that host country continues to harbor terrorist organizations, continues to support them, and continues to support their ends, then we'll need to do what we need to do, even if that means unilaterally acting to intervene and to aggress against that particular or respond to that particular threat. Now, that's got to be part of our response now. We're not dealing any longer with identified nations who are opposed to us. These cells, these operative organizations, we need to be ready to respond to. Now, we should work with other nations, clearly. But America needs to do what it needs to do to protect its citizens, protect its country, and protect its vital interests around the world.
Thank you. Ms. Ayotte.
We need to protect the United States of America. The fundamental purpose of government is national security. And if we had to take a step, if Al-Qaeda is in another country, we should take whatever means we can short of military action. But if we have to take military action unilaterally, we need to do it to protect America. My husband served in the Iraq War and fought for us there. And I can tell you, I know now with our troops serving over in Afghanistan, they need to know that we are behind them and that we have the intestinal fortitude to root out terrorism wherever it is to make sure that Americans are protected. We will do that when we can, cooperating with our allies and working with other countries. But if we have to act unilaterally, we can and we must have the fortitude to do so to protect America.
Thank you. Mr. Binney.
The first role of the federal government is to protect the homeland and the citizens of the United States of America, wherever they may be. Terrorism, unfortunately and regrettably, is a real fact of life. It will be for the lives of all of the people up in this stage and, sadly, maybe even our children. It's a real fact. We should be realistic, determined, and honest with our citizens about the threats and the dangers. If Al-Qaeda is in a host country, we need to work diligently with those host countries to make sure that they are not a threat to America. We should be careful but keep all options on the table. And as a United States senator, I would do exactly that. Keep all options on the table. Be firm and determined and make sure that we do the best job that we can, the absolute best job with giving the right tools to our military to make sure that this threat of terrorism is contained.
Thank you.